snow was falling, and God told him to speak. And when he spoke, he told the sun to come and shine again. That's why I like this song. Amen. God bless you. So let us sing, I have the Maker. I am the Maker. Thank you. So, I will start our Sunday school. And I will speak about Joseph. This thing is not working. So let us stand for the reading of the word. Genesis chapter 41, we take verse 44. It's not working. Okay, let us read together. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, I am Pharaoh, and without thee shall no man lift up his hand or foot in all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Zaphnath-Paaneah, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar's priest of On. And Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt. Lord Jesus, bless the reading of the word in the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 It's been a city. So, we are going to continue with the story of Joseph. And our title was what? What was the title? The main title of this one? Joseph's faith. Amen. So, we spoke about Joseph's faith, how Joseph trusted the Lord. Okay? So, who's going to tell me what we've been studying about Joseph with me? Yes, Sister Rebecca.
I was talking about when Joseph was interpreting the two big articles.
Thank you very much. So, Joseph was interpreting some dreams of the butler and the butler and the baker. And Joseph said one of them is supposed to go back to the king and to be restored in his place. And one of them supposed to die. And Barbara said that Joseph was the type of Jesus Christ. It was like Jesus Christ when he was on the cross, yeah, with two people, both sides. One died and one was saved. And we saw that Joseph was taken from the prison. He was brought to the house of the king, and Joseph could interpret the songs, the dreams, yeah? So what was the dream of the king? Yes, Sister Erica.
That all the spirit was getting put back
out. Exactly, and
when the unhealthy dreams ate the
weak. Yeah, so thank you. And both dreams was telling the same thing, exactly the same thing. So praise be to God. And now, after interpreting those dreams, and the king decided now to give Joseph the second place of the land. And Joseph became like the second person of in the land of Egypt. Amen. And the Bible says that, and Pharaoh said unto Joseph, I am Pharaoh, that means I'm the king. And without thee shall no man lift up his hand or foot in all the land of Egypt. Amen. So everything is supposed to be done according to the order of Joseph. So Joseph was the one who was giving order to the people. Before to do anything, Joseph was the second personality in the kingdom. But I want you to notice something here. Remember that Joseph is the type of Jesus Christ. So, the Bible says that, and Pharaoh called Joseph's name, who? Zaphnath-Hanel. So, his name was changed. Amen. Amen. So remember, Joseph is the type of Jesus. So, let's say this is Joseph, okay? Okay? This is Joseph. So, the king changed his name, called his name Zaphnath-Hanel. Okay. And in the land of Israel, the house of Jacob, they knew that his name was
Joseph.
Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
Different names, but still the same person, isn't it? So if you say Zaphnath-Hanel, is still Joseph. And if you say Joseph, it's still Zaphnath-Hanel. Amen. So you are going to notice that so many, all the children born in Egypt, they didn't know even the name of Joseph. They knew that his name was Zaphnath-Hanel. Amen. So his name was changed, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, priest of old. So the wife of Joseph was from Egypt. So Egypt means the Gentile wife. So he took the wife from the Gentile country, Gentile land. Amen. So you notice something here. Joseph, his name was changed from Joseph to Zaphnath-Hanel. But in his heart, he knew that his name was Joseph. Do you understand? So he could walk on the street. They could call him Zaphnath-Hanel. He could turn and see who's calling me. But in his heart, he knew that his name was Joseph. Amen. So you can see some. You can see someone, for example, from the house of Jacob. Just an example. Come to the land of Egypt and sees Joseph. You say, oh, this is Joseph. And someone from Egypt said, no, this is not Joseph. This is Zaphnath-Hanel. Amen. But they are saying the same thing. Do you understand? Zaphnath-Hanel wasn't his name. His name was Joseph. When he was born, he was given the name of Joseph. But when he goes to the land of Egypt, they changed his name. Amen. And the Bible says that all the families, amen, on the earth and heaven is called Jesus. Amen. So the name of the family is Jesus. It's like in the house, when the name of the family is, let's say, McDonald, all the family's name will be McDonald. You say James McDonald. You see Michael McDonald, you see whatever. Do you understand? So everyone will have a name, but at the end of the name will be McDonald. Do you understand? So, let's say the family name is Maloka. So you'll be given the name Eric, is your name. But the family name is Malonga. That means everyone in the family will take that name of Malonga. So if you are in the family of Jesus Christ, your name will be Jesus. Do you understand? So the bride of Christ, I mean the children of Jesus, of Christ, of God, they are all called Jesus. But when you came in this world, they gave you the name to identify you. Because if you start calling everyone Jesus, there will be a bit confusion, isn't it? So we are all Jesus.
So Jesus, everyone is going to town. Did you call me? So we gave the names to make the difference. Your name is Israel, your name is Rebecca, your name is Erica, your name is Joe, whatever. Amen. But your true name is not Israel. To begin with, before your birth, you wasn't called Israel. Amen. But you didn't start where you was born. You started before your birth. Amen. You even never start. Are you with me? So when we're talking about eternity, so you came from eternity, amen, and you came in the time, what you call the body, let's say like this, okay? This is time, and this is eternity, okay? And this is eternity as well. Okay? I'll represent it like this. But what I'm saying is that eternity doesn't have a beginning, doesn't have an end. And there's a point here we can call time. Amen? Or your body. So this is eternity. Okay? The Bible says, but when I say that we came from eternity, we are going back to eternity. So when you came here, when you was here, your name was Jesus. Okay? Because you was in God. You understand? If you are a son of God, that means you are part of God. When God was created, he was in you. Okay? And when you was born, you came in the body, okay? That body is time. It started when you was born. That's why you always celebrate your birthday. Are you with me? But your birthday is not your beginning. Are you with me? You didn't start there from your birth. If you are from eternity, you didn't start there, you started from eternity. Where you didn't have the name of Israel, okay? But your name was Jesus. But after your birth, you was given the name of Israel, just to identify you. But your real name is Jesus. You understand? So, people may call you Israel, that's fine. But it's not your real name. Because if you partake in the family of God, your name must be Jesus, because the name of the Father is Jesus. Amen. If I'm the part of the family of Brother Eric, my name must be Maronga. Yeah. Because everyone in my family is called Maronga. So in the family of Jesus, everyone is called Jesus. So when you came in the time in the body, you was given the name of Israel. But once you get out of this body, yeah? Israel is no longer living, but Jesus still living. And you get in the body called, by what I'm called, Theophany, or the glorified body. Okay? Or glorified body. Let's look at this. But there you're still living, okay? But the name of Israel will go away. But the name of Jesus still until there. You understand? That's what we call eternity. Your name is there. So Joseph, he was given the name of Joseph in Egypt. Let's say the world, what we call Egypt. Okay? And the half of Jacob is what we call eternity. So according to eternity, his name was Joseph. But when he came in this life, I mean, in the life of Egypt, he was given the name of Zaphnath-Paneah. So, you tell me, who could recognize his real name? It's only his brethren. You understand? Even his brethren, they were lost before Joseph. When they came before Joseph, they were afraid of him.
You know the story. Joseph said, Joseph put his cup in their son. So after they said, oh, someone stole my cup. So let us find it. And he said, no, it's not ours. It's not me. It's not me. It's not me. So they went to found it in someone's son. Benjamin. And Joseph said, all right, you are thieves. Can you remember?
Yes.
Now, you notice, Joseph was standing before them. Amen. He watched his brothers. He knew them, but they didn't recognize him. So, until Joseph told them that, I am your brother. And from that time, Joseph told them his real name. You understand? They were lost. Amen. So when Jesus, amen, when Jesus came in the land of Gentile, he took another name. Amen. He was called William Branham. Who's Jesus? Jesus is the pillar of fire dwelling in someone, in a man, and that man's name was William Branham. Amen. We know that his name is William Branham. But if you are part of the family of Jacob, you know that the pillar of fire is not Branham, but the pillar of fire is the Lord Jesus Christ. Are you with me? Because when the pillar of fire met Paul in his road to Damascus, he said, I am Jesus. You understand? So the same Jesus came again to the Gentiles and changed his name. He was called William Branham. So the people of Kentucky, they could see just a little humble man. They said, oh, we know him. He was born in Kentucky and his name is William Branham. Amen. Like in Egypt, we could say, oh, we know this man. He's our boss. He's the second person in the line. His name is Zaphnath Paneah. But someone who belongs in the family knew that his name was Joseph. And notice something. Joseph wasn't recognized by his brethren, but Joseph revealed himself. Amen. So there's no way for you to know Jesus if Jesus doesn't reveal himself to you. So there was nothing they could do to recognize their brother. Because they were standing there for a long time, they didn't know him. Why? Because he was dressed as an Egyptian. Amen. So today in the message, people are expecting to see Jesus Christ with the rainbow. Amen. With the beard, with his long hair. Amen. But Jesus, when he comes in the end time, he must change his clothes. And what I'm going to say that the cloth of God is the human being.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we call the cloth of God. The prophet is the coat of God. God is spirit. If God wants to dress himself, he's going to take the body of a prophet. Are you with me? And the coat's name is William Branham. But the man who is wearing the coat, his name is the Lord Jesus Christ. So when Joseph went to Egypt, he even changed the way of he was dressing. Amen. He was dressed as an Egyptian. Amen. Everything was an Egyptian. Even he changed his appearance. Totally different. That's why we don't believe in makeup. So if you do makeup, you change your appearance. Amen. I know someone. He saw a girl and said, oh, I will get married to you. So that girl was so pretty. And the guy said, oh, I will get married to you. Oh, so beautiful girl. And the man went to present himself to the family and he took the wife. So when he took the wife to the house, in his house, and in the morning that woman went to wash his face, her face. When she washed her face, and the guy found that it's not
The woman was looking for, so the appearance changed. So she was looking like something else. And the guy said, oh, listen, that's not what I was looking for. So yeah, I'm still the same person. The guy said, no, because you had makeup. I thought you was pretty, but actually you are not. So I'm sorry. So now is the end of the marriage. So you tell me, whose fault? Whose fault? The woman's fault. So you need to show yourself the way you are. Amen. Can you remember someone like Joseph? Can you imagine Joseph was their body? Amen. Joseph was living with them in the same house. Joseph was with them all the time. But after 40 years, they met the same man, Joseph. They couldn't recognize him. Amen. So let's say this one is only in the physical form. Okay. So if the children of Israel could forget their own God, now tell me, how people are going to recognize Jesus Christ when he comes back? That's totally impossible. That's why Abraham said, if you want to recognize Jesus, just check what he done in his first coming. Then you'll do the same when you see someone doing exactly the same according to what he done before. That's gonna be the Lord Jesus Christ. Doesn't matter what kind of cloth is gonna put on him. Doesn't matter what appearance is gonna have, but the only thing you need to check is to see what Joseph did. What Jesus did. So you do the same today. And but the Bible was saying that the way the woman on the world recognized Jesus Christ, it was because Jesus could what deserves the fault of her. Amen. So doesn't matter how he was looking like, but when Jesus deserved the fault of her heart, she said, sir, I perceive that you are the prophet. So you must notice that Joseph will change his appearance when he comes to the Gentiles, to the nations. He will change his appearance. When he was in Egypt, he was even rejected. When he comes here, so you notice that in the land of Israel, to Jacob's house, there wasn't any food. So the only way to find food, it was to go to Egypt. Are you familiar? So simple, isn't it? So you see how people are misled in the message, looking for something which took place already. It's like Israel people today, they stay expecting for the Messiah to come when the Messiah came 2,000 years ago. Until today, they're still expecting to see the Messiah come when they're missing the Messiah. And it's happening the same to the Gentiles. And notice, Joseph didn't go back to the land of Egypt. He didn't go. Joseph was living in the land of Egypt. Amen. And his brethren, his family, came to meet him in Egypt. Who's Joseph? The Lord Jesus Christ. And Balaam said that when he came in his first coming, he was rejected by his brothers. And the Bible says that because he was rejected, he gave us the power to become the children of God. And the Bible says, as he was with Israel, he came down to the Gentiles. Are you with me? So when now he's living the Gentile, he changed his name. And Balaam said that the seven church ages, amen. Seven church ages was Jesus Christ on the candlestick. Are you familiar?
Amen.
So in the age of Ephesus, he changed his name, he took the name of Paul. Okay? So forth. Until the last age, he took the name of William Bonham. But his name still Jesus. Are you familiar? His name doesn't change. So the only way to recognize him, you must come from his family. And then he's going to reveal himself to you. So you notice that after Joseph revealing himself to his family, all the Egyptians still calling him Zaphnath-Paneah. Are you with me? But the family knew that was Joseph. So in the secret, but I want to say that before Joseph to reveal himself to his brethren, Joseph took all the Egyptians out of the house. Why? Because that secret was only for the people of the family. Are you with me? So if you don't belong in the family of Christ, so there's no way for you to get a revelation. You must be a part of the family, then God is going to reveal himself to you. He'll tell you, see, I am Jesus Christ. No, I know that your name is Barabara. He said, yes, the body is Barabara, but the inside of that body is the Lord Jesus Christ. One day, Barabara was planning to go out, to go to the restaurant to eat with brothers and Brother Billy Paul. Before to go out, you know what is called, Barabara didn't have hair there. So, if he doesn't cover his head, he's going to get sore throat. And Barabara was putting a wig on top of his head, just to protect himself. He wasn't hiding his body head, but he was protecting himself. Instead of putting a hat, he was putting a wig. So when Barabara was planning to go out, and Barabara people came to meet Barabara, he said, oh, Dad, what are you doing? He said, yeah, we are going out. Say, do you mean that you're going to go out with the wig you got? Barabara said, which one will fit? He said, no, if you go like this, I'm not going with you. And Barabara said, okay, Billy, you can go. When people went, then he said, I know my dad is not happy. Let me go back and see him. When he came back to Barabara, he said, Dad, I know that you are not happy about what I said. And Barabara said, Billy, come. He said, Billy, you are my son. I don't care what you can tell me, I'll forgive you. But the thing is, that person, the one who's living in me, didn't like what you said. Can you notice that? Who is the person, the one who's living in Barabara? It was the Lord Jesus Christ himself. So Barabara in the body said, Billy, I don't have any problem with that. No problem, you're still my son. I'll forgive you. But the one who's living in me didn't like what you said. And if you didn't come back to me, he was ready to kill you straight away. And Billy Paul was so sorry. He said, Dad, I'm so sorry. I will never do something like this. Amen. I don't know. One day, Brother Joseph Barnum, did something wrong. And Sister Mina said, oh, Joseph, you don't listen. Wait, when your dad is going to come, he's going to slap you. And Brother Joseph knew exactly his dad. He knew that, oh, my dad is a preacher. Amen. So when Barabara was preaching, Brother Joseph was saying, preach, dad, preach. So he was very close friend to his dad. He was the last one, listen. And when Barabara came in the house, before Sister Mida to tell Barabara what Joseph did, Joseph went to Barabara and said, Dad, I did something wrong. I'm so sorry. So what is that? He said, Mom is going to tell you, but I'm so angry, Dad. He said, okay, that's fine. You still my son. And when Barabara went there, saw Sister Mida, said, oh, Billy, I was waiting for you. He said, which one? He said, Joseph is a bad boy. He done this and that. He said, honey, Joseph, I just met Joseph. He said sorry to me. He said, what? You have to correct him. He's a bad boy. He said, I can't do it because he said sorry. And Sister Mina was angry to Barabara and just closed the door. Bam! And God didn't like it. And God told Barabara, he said, Billy, Barabara,
What did Mila did that to you? I didn't like it. But Abraham said that, oh God, that's my problem. She's still my wife. She's the one who's watching my growth, everything. She's supporting me in prayers. God said, yes, I know. But I didn't like what it is. So go pray for her. Because she's got a tumor, she's gonna die. And Balaban went to Sister Mira. He said, honey, you know that I love you. I'm your husband. Whatever you can tell me, I'll forgive you. So when Sister Mira told Balaban what Joseph did, when he banged the door, Balaban didn't make it any problem. Didn't make it a big issue at all. But I want to just ignore it. Say, oh, she's a person. Maybe she's unhappy. Oh, it's okay. But God, inside of William Barham, didn't like it. So Barham went to Sister Mila and said, Mila, see what you did there? Say, yes, Billy. You banged the door after me. Say, oh, Billy, I'm sorry about that. Say, no, it's not a problem. For me, it's not a problem. But God didn't like it. So he said, you've got a tumor. Now, if I don't pray for you, you're going to die. Come, I'm going to pray for you. I'm telling you, since that time, Sister Mila started to speak. She was respecting God about me, but she was angry. Can you understand? So it was so hard for Sister Mila to live with such husband. Amen. So I'm going to bring it down now. The reason why God about preaching respect, because when someone is a child of God, that means God is living in that person. That's the reason you have to respect everyone. If you call someone brother, you call someone sister, that means he is a part of God. That means God is living in that person. So you have to respect. You understand? And when you respect each other, you'll be together. And you'll be strong. I've got a lesson one day I'm gonna bring it to you. It's about, I was talking about the rope. Do the rope. Yeah, the rope. Yeah. Do the rope. Yeah. So, explain to yourself what you want to say. Yeah. So the rope is made with small strings, isn't it? Very small strings. They are just small strings, put them all together. You understand? So if you take that small string alone, anyone can break it. Anyone can cut it like this. But if you put them together, when they're stacking together, they can even pull the airplane, even the boat. You understand? So, bend together, respecting each other, bend together as children of God, it makes us strong. You understand? And Satan will never move you or me when we are standing together. So the only way Satan to break you, he must separate you. By what? Giving you something bad against your brother, against your sister. Once you start thinking like that, straight away, Satan is among you. But Abraham said that, never see yourself bigger than the other one. You must always see yourself small. Be humble. Humble yourself towards your brother or your sister. Amen. It's very important. So, come back to Joseph. I'm closing soon. So Joseph, he's the most changed. And he was given the name of Zaphnath Paneah. And Joseph had two sons. Amen? The Bible says, and unto Joseph were born two sons before the years of famine came, which Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, priest of On, bare unto him. And Joseph called their name, the name of the firstborn who? Manasseh. What's that means? For God said, he had made me forget all my toil and all my father's house. So, notice that Joseph gave the name of his son, Manasseh. Why? Because Joseph was trying to forget everything took place. What kind of faith is this one? So you must be like Joseph. So you're still keeping bad things in your heart. Why? Oh, that day he did this one to me. That day he was bad to me. I don't like him because of this and this. Amen. So if you got someone who you don't like because he was bad to you, straight away now, take it out of your heart. Amen. So feel about Manasseh. Joseph said, because God gave him everything and he forgot all the toil. I mean, the toil is the suffering. So I was betrayed by my brother, but I don't care, I just forgive. It was for my good. It was God's plan. Amen. So everything is taking place in your life, you must know that it's God's plan. So his name was he gave the name of his son Manasseh because God made him to forget all his troubles. I mean, all his sufferings. And all my father's house. So he said now, in that time, no WhatsApp, no Facebook, no Instagram, no even the telephone. So if you are separated from your family, it's very hard to get in touch. So Joseph now, he didn't know what is taking place. That means that Joseph in his heart, he was suffering, thinking, oh, how's my brother? My brother's, oh, how's my dad? What's taking place now? Is my dad dead? My mom is dead or what? You must know when Joseph met his family, his mom died already. Amen. So during the time he was in Egypt, his mom died. So Joseph couldn't stop thinking about his family. He said, oh, if I just think about my family, I'll suffer more. He said, okay, let me give the name of my son, Manasseh. That means I forget all my house. So I just make my life in Egypt. And you notice that Joseph had two sons. Joseph was the son of Jacob. But his wife was from the Gentile, from Egypt. Amen. And they had two children. Those two children was half Gentile and half Israel. Gentile is Egypt. Are you with me? So Manasseh and Ephraim, they were both Gentiles and Egyptian and nations. So you notice that because Joseph is in the family of Jacob, automatically his two children also, they belong in the family. But they had a part of nation in them. So we bring that, see what is bringing together Israel and the nation. Are you feeling? Are you feeling? It's so simple. So if the people in the message, they can see this way in this way, it's going to be very simple to understand the message. That's the reason why I'm preaching about Joseph. The life of Joseph, Joseph meeting his brother. So next time we're going to see Joseph meeting his brother. So the day Joseph met his brother, he brought all his family with him. Even the bride, which was Asenath, which was from Egypt, came now in the family. She was a Gentile bride, but she got in the family of Israel, and Manasseh and Ephraim also came in the family. Both together now making just one family. That family was made both Gentiles and Israelites. Are you with me? And what I said that the fourth mystery is the church made with Gentile and Israel both together. And the Bible says there's no difference between, there's no difference, there's no Israelites, Jewish, there's no Gentile, when everybody is in Christ. Are you feeling? So Joseph meeting his brethren is Joseph uniting in Egypt and Israel together. So next time we see Joseph meeting his brother. So I'll just stop in there. God bless you.
Thank you.
things, that's why I walk my feet.